There is no doubt that religion has permeated nearly all facets of human existence. No matter our belief system, we must acknowledge that the idea of singular or multiple deities has greatly influenced the trajectory of human civilization. Most scholars and scientists agree that humanity began in Africa, and so it would be a bit disingenuous to think that religion developed first outside of the African continent. And so today, I wanted to speak about what one scholar has to say concerning the origin of African religion. What up, African world? It's Home Team here, and welcome back to another video of African history, culture, and worldview. By supporting this channel on Patreon, you're helping in the creation of these videos and contributing to this content. On Patreon, you can find more in-depth courses on African history. The link to Patreon is in the description box below. To begin, it's virtually impossible to point to any location in Africa and claim that this is the spot in which religion was first formulated. It's really not that simple. One scholar named Deji Ayegboyen has a great article in the Encyclopedia of African Religion that covers this topic. I thought his ideas about the origin of religion in Africa was worthy of note, and so we'll be borrowing from his ideas primarily. Most of this video will be a sort of philosophical sparring session between African history and the origin of religion, and thus should not be taken as an all-conclusive truth. I think what Deji Ayegboyen gives us is a foundation that can be used to study early African religion, a tangible outline we can build off of to understand the very concept of religion itself from an African perspective. So let's begin. A powerful fact that Deji Ayegboyen points out about the concept of religion in Africa concerns African languages itself. According to him, there aren't any words in African languages that refer to religion as a specific activity. He points out that the idea of religion is a borrowed concept coming from the influences of Europeans and Arabs. The question of polytheism or monotheism is not an African question and has limited value in trying to understand how Africans came to view their lives and those of their neighbors. One does not have to draw sharp distinctions between those who believe in many deities and those who purport to believe in one deity to gain an appreciation of the complexity of the African way of life. In fact, most Africans accept a belief in one creator deity, although there may be many spirits. Thus, in reality, this is similar to the later forms of religion which follow the African pattern in many respects. Now, Professor Deji doesn't elaborate further on this particular quote, but I imagine he may be speaking about how monotheistic religions such as Christianity and Islam worship one supreme deity, but still have lesser powerful entities such as angels or demons. Deji seems to suggest that though these religions are far removed, it still follows what he calls an African pattern. Before we go more in depth with African religion, there are some useful scholarly speculations about why religion came to be in the first place. Deji Ayegboyen discusses some of these general theories and applies them to African people. These theories include psychological, intellectual, emotional, and others. Proponents of the psychological theory claim that early Africans created gods or supernatural beings as a result of ignorance, fears, and anxiety. The intellectual theory maintains that early Africans were trying to make sense of the world around them. I find the emotional theory to be the most interesting. Emotional theorists propose that religious beliefs arose from emotions. They maintain that early African religion was not something thought out, but rather danced out to forestall the mounting of fear and anxiety in conditions where success is uncertain. According to Deji Ayegboyen, if we conceptualize so-called African religion as simply an extension of a particular African ethnic group's way of life, instead of a separate identity altogether, as we sometimes do in the West, then the origins of African religion become a little less vague, morphing into a philosophical utility that holds more weight. It appears that the idea of responding to the environment, relationships, and mysteries might have occurred so far in antiquity that we will never know the precise origin of human response to the universe. Nevertheless, these early attempts to explain the environment may be called the origins of religion when defined as a way of life. I think the one thing we can point to concerning the origin of religion that's tangible is the origin of monotheism. There does seem to be some direct documentation that speaks to the concept of one God. Documentation that points in one location, and it began on the African continent. Africans were the first humans to conceive of a concept of monotheism, and Akhenaten has been considered the first person to have commented on the idea of one God. Of course, there is ample evidence to note that many African traditions accepted that the supreme deity was too distant to deal with daily issues. These were left for the interventions of ancestors and other spirits. Even though we cannot conclusively say African religion began here or there, I think we can begin challenging our own paradigms on religion and rethink how we view the concept of religion on the African continent. I think at the very least, Deji Ayegboyen has helped us to dispel our assumptions about the question itself. Well, I'm all out, guys. If you like these videos and want to help in its continued production, consider supporting the home team on patreon.com. The link is in the description box below. Know thyself. Remember your ancestors. Peace.